Hey guys, this is Tom from The Balanced Singer here, and today we are going to be doing a vocal coach react video to Celine Dion singing her new song, Courage, live. So yeah, I've been a massive Celine Dion fan for a long time. I think probably the first time I heard Celine's voice was on the soundtrack to the film Up Close and Personal. That really popular song, Because You Love Me, was in the UK charts for ages. First time I ever saw Celine live was when she came to Murrayfield Stadium in Edinburgh in July 1999. I remember being very excited to go and see that. Next time I got to see her was when she came to Manchester in 2007. I was very lucky to sit front row both nights. Really enjoyed that. Next time I saw her was August 2016 when she came back to Scotland for the first time in almost 20 years. So sat in the second row there and absolutely loved the concert. It was really great. Good to see a taste of her Vegas show. And then I'm really looking forward to seeing her in September this year, September 2020, when she's coming back to Glasgow with her Courage tour. Sadly, I've never managed to make it to Vegas to see her. Every time I was in Las Vegas, she was out of town or was taking a break. So very sad, but at least I'm getting to see her again live. So today we're looking at a recording of Celine singing the song Courage, and this was recorded live in September 2019 when she was starting her world tour, and I believe it's recorded in Canada. Some of the comments are talking about how Celine was ill that night. She had a viral infection and had cancelled the show the night before, and so it'll be interesting to see how she's doing. Remember, she basically finished her residency in Las Vegas and had about a month off and then went straight back on tour again. So. Okay, so here we go. I would be lying if I said I'm fine. I think of you at least 100 times. Holland chess voice. Listen to the echo of my voice, I hear your words just like you did. So lovely. So we're going from a breathier chess voice to a little bit more reduction to a bit more of a spoken sound back to the breathy again. Celine's very good at doing that kind of thing in her chest voice. So far, so good. I still come home from a long day. Bit more voice here. So much to talk about, so much to say. I love to think that we're still making plans in conversations that I'll never end. There's that breathy tone again. In conversations that I'll never end. It's lovely, nice. So we're at the top of her chest voice there in that word courage. Yeah, there's a little bit of a cry there. As some of the comments said, she is ill, so she could be suffering from a little bit of swelling in her vocal cords, which means the vocal cords puff up and it's much harder for them to stretch and thin to reach those high notes. So we'll see what happens as that note comes around. It comes around quite a few times. So straight away I'm noticing though that the song has been lower by an entire tone. In this version that we're listening to, the chorus, that Courage, was an F4 to D4. And the album version is a G4 to an E4. So she has lowered the song to try and make it easier for herself, which is very common with artists. They do lower the songs half a semitone or a whole tone in some instances. So we'll see how that works for her as the song progresses. So courage, don't you dare fail me now. I want to hide from the truth. Little bit of vocal fry there in the chest, boys. Out of my hands, but I won't let you go. There's no place in the way you touched me. Lovely flicker. Still feel the rush. So she's just going from breathy to more voice to breathy to more voice, using little bits of vocal fry and a little bit of an edgier sound every now and then for the emotion. So really good. Sometimes it drowns me till I can't breathe. Ooh, more voice there. And back it off again. But then I talk to you like I did then. In conversation that I love. And breath here again. Lovely, that chest voice. I need you to keep away now. Here comes his B flat again. Better, but still not quite. So forgetting technique for a second, let's talk about the song. This is such a beautiful song. So well written and just so timely for everything that's happening to Celine in her life just now. Songwriters did a phenomenal job with this one and I can really see why they picked it for the album. That B flat 4 came around again and whilst it was better than the first time, it was still a little under pitch on the note. She's not quite locking into the pitch. So we were talking about the vocal cords being a little puffy from the fact that she could be ill. So what happens is that when we sing up towards a higher pitch, the vocal cords stretch and thin. So when they're puffy, it's much harder for them to stretch and thin to the correct pitch. So while she's in the region of the note, she's not just locking right onto the absolute pitch, which is what you can hear. So something that's not helping her just now though is the vowel in the words. The line is staring at the face. So that A sound is not exactly encouraging the vocal cords to thin out. It's actually encouraging them to thicken up a little bit more. If that was more steering, to work like steering a car, that might help her to thin the cords out and get up to that pitch. So that's one thing that she could do. She could modify that vowel a little bit. We're just about to go into the bridge now, and there's a couple of E's on these higher notes. So we're going to see, we want to see if this makes a difference to her, if she's able to get up to that pitch. There you go, yeah. So straight away, cause it's not E. That E sound is really helping her. She went straight to that B flat 4 without any problem. Cause you're not with me. There was a little bit of E in there that was helping her. Again, she went straight to the pitch. So you see the difference between the stare and the we gets her right to the place. Now, so straight away on that line, cause it's not easy. That E is more closed than the A was before. What that's doing is it's allowing and encouraging those vocal cords to thin out and find that pitch that she's looking for. Because you're not with me, it is a little bit more open than the E, but it's still thinner and helping her to get all the way up to that pitch. What we hear though is when she goes for the word madness, which is again on that B flat 4, because she's been up there twice now already with the more closed vowels, the E and the A, it's helping her muscle memory of her voice to remember how to get back up there. So she's actually doing a much better job in the more open vowel this time round. So what will be really interesting to see is that when we get to the final chorus of the song, is if she's able to maintain that and get back up there in the B flat 4. Okay, so let's keep going. She's doing better on the A and train. A little bit of crack there though, a little bit of a wobble. So she did do better on the A on the train wreck, but you could hear that there was a bit of a wobble there. It wasn't quite as stable as she liked. She kept going though. She didn't stop. Her face didn't say, oh crap, what happened? She just kept going for it. So maybe the A destabilized her voice a little bit, but she did recover nicely. So let's keep going, let's see what happens now. It does look great with the new haircut as well. Good, straight up to it. Good, much better. A little under there though, but good. So she was a little bit under on the madness this time, and the faster wasn't quite as strong as it had been the first time round on this section. So she's maybe starting to get a little bit tired through the song. Let's see. Yeah, there's that crack again. And it was a great start. Just at the end of the note, she just lost it. But it was a much stronger second time round on the word train than the first time. Good on the echo. Nice breathy tone. So much presence here. Oh, just great. Yeah, great stuff. So it's Celine. We love Celine. So yeah, there's definitely a little bit of something going on in her voice tonight. The song has been lowered, whether that's just the key that she's performing it in or whether they had to lower the key for this particular performance, we won't know. But lots of kind of interesting technique stuff. As we mentioned, there's the parts where the more open vowels, the A and the A's, are causing her to be a little under pitch, a little flat. But when she gets to the bridge, the E's and the I's are helping her to get up there and get right onto that pitch. And for the most part, she was able to maintain it. What threw her though was when she got to the A vowel again in the train wreck line. And it just caused those chords to thicken up a bit. So it's still a phenomenal performance, and I really can't wait to see this performance live myself. And I just hope that gives you a little bit of insight in how those vowels can affect the voice differently and how you can see that in a singer singing live in the same song. You know, and also thinking about what's been going on in Celine's life, you know, sadly her husband died and her brother died as well, all in a very short time space. So this song probably has a lot of emotions and feelings for her. So there's bound to be some of that emotion coming through and causing a little bit of cracks and things in the song. And we don't mind, because that's what makes a singer human, and that's what makes us relate to the song and the story that they're telling. You know, this video isn't to take Celine apart and criticise her for these wobbly notes. It's to say, hey, you know, this is what happened. This is what could have made it better, but it's still a great performance and we still loved it. So that's it, guys. We'd love to know what you thought about this performance. Did you enjoy it? Did those couple of little issues put you off? Could you feel the emotion coming across from Celine in that? Leave us a comment below and let us know what you thought. If there's any other singers or artists that you'd like to see us react to, why not leave us a comment below with the name of the artist, the song, and even better if you have a link to the video. It's better if you can leave us a link to a live performance of the song. Sometimes the studio versions have enhancements on them that disguise some of the things that the singer is doing. So for us to get a really true analysis, live recordings are much better. So I hope that was helpful. I hope you enjoyed this. Make sure to subscribe and click that little bell to get notifications next time we release a video. And until then, have a great day.